Welcome you all. Myself Dipali Jain and I am working as an assistant professor in KKWA College of Pharmacy, Nashik. Today I am here with the extraction technique. So let us start with the definition of extraction. So what is meant by extraction? It is a separation technique which is used to separate the active constituents from the mixture. Solubilizing the active constituent and removing it with a suitable extracting solvent is the most common technique followed in the field of analysis. So, what is meant by extraction? It is the separation technique which is used to find out or separate out the active constituent from the mixture. The extraction method can be classified into two categories. First one is solid-liquid extraction and second one is liquid-liquid extraction. In both the types, there are various methods and devices which are adopted for complete separation of one or more active constituents which are present in the given mixture. These methods are of continuous or discontinuous or stepwise extraction type. So let us start with the first type, that is solid phase extraction. It is also denoted by SPE method. Solid phase extraction, it is the technique in which hydrophobic functional groups are bonded to solid particle surface and act as the extracting phase. They reduce the need for large volumes of organic solvents. SPE consists of bringing a liquid or gaseous test sample in contact with a solid phase whereby the analyte is selectively adsorbed on the surface of the solid phase. Okay, so here in this method, the compounds or constituent are separated out by using the solid phase and liquid phase. The use of solid phase extraction, which has become a widely used technique for a sample cleanup and concentration prior to chromatographic analysis in particular. In this technique, a particular type of organic functional group is chemically bonded to a solid surface, for example, powdered silica. A common example is the bonding of C18 chains on silica with particle size on the order of 40 micrometer. The bonded hydrocarbon creates a virtual liquid phase into which hydrophobic organic analytes in an aqueous sample can partition and can be extracted. There are a variety of different types of phases commercially available with different polarities. The same solid phases used in high performance liquid chromatography are used for solid phase extraction except in a larger particle size. So let us see the principle of SPE. So this solid phase extraction method involves four steps. Okay. Conditioning, retention, rinsing and elution. So in this conditioning step, conditioning the sorbent prior to sample application ensures reproducible retention of the compound of interest. What is meant by retention? Where adsorb isolate in which undesired matrix constituent are find out and other undesired matrix components are separated. Then rinsing, the rinse the column to remove other undesired matrix components. And what is meant by elution? Purified and concentrated isolate ready for analysis, undesired component remain. Okay, so these are the four steps which involve the solid phase extraction method. A typical sequence in a solid phase extraction involves four steps following conditioning. The analyte and other sample constituent are adsorbed on the sorbent extraction bed. Then rinsing step removes some of the undesired constituents while elution removes the desired analyte, perhaps leaving other constituent behind depending on the relative strength of interaction with solid phase or solubility in the eliting solvent. Such a procedure is used for the determination of organic compounds in drinking water in the Official Environmental Protection Agency, that is EPA method. In this SPE method, let us see the instrument which is used. So in this method, we use SPE cartridge. Okay, so here in the diagram, you can see this is the SPE cartridge. The SPE sorbent is pre-pack in polypropylene syringe with typically 500 mg of packing in 3 or 5 ml syringe barrels. Smaller 1 ml syringes packed with 100 mg are becoming more popular because of reduced sample and solvent requirement and faster cleanup times, and even smaller pack beds down to 10 mg are also available. These smaller packings, of course, have smaller capacity. Larger ones may be required for preparing large volumes of environmental samples such as polluted water that has large amount of contaminants to be removed. Okay, so this solid phase extraction method is used to separate out the component. Okay, for that purpose we require the instrument. Here we use SPE cartridge. Okay, so here syringe is present, then adapter, here eluent or sample, solid phase extractor on the wall of the syringe. Okay, and there is at the end, here is the removal of components. Okay, the SPA cartridges are used for the isolation and concentration of drugs from biological samples and are typically processed in batches of 12 to 24 using vacuum manifolds. There are automated liquid handling systems to improve the efficiency. SPA cartridges are generally considered to be for a single use and disposable. However, cost can be a significant issue if a large number of samples are to be processed. Okay, so this is the advantage, disadvantage, sorry. These are the advantages and disadvantage for SPE cartridges. Now, let us see the working of SPE cartridges. The powdered phase is generally placed in a small cartridge similar to a plastic syringe. Sample is placed in the cartridge and forced through by means of a plunger. Okay, means positive pressure is applied, or a vacuum, that is negative pressure, or by centrifugation. Okay, by using this procedure we can apply the force. Trace organic molecules can be extracted, pre-concentrated on the column and separated away from the sample matrix. Then they can be eluted with a solvent such as methanol and finally analyzed, for example by chromatography method. They may be further concentrated prior to analysis by evaporating the solvent. So this is the working principle of SPE cartridge. The nature of the extracting phase, particularly the type of bonded functional group, can be varied to allow extraction of different classes of compounds. Bonded phases based on van der Waals forces, hydrogen bonding or dipolar attraction and electrostatic attraction. Okay, so these are the principle behind the SPE method. Okay, so here bonded phases are based on the van der Waals forces, hydrogen bonding forces or electrostatic attraction. Here you can see in this diagram, this is the silica base where when we apply the van der Waals forces, bonded functional group are present, then dipolar attraction or hydrogen bonding. Here you can see how this bonding is occur. Okay, and last one is the electrostatic attraction. Okay, so this is about the solid phase extractant utilizing nonpolar, polar and electrostatic interactions. Now second instrument which is used for this method is SPE pipette tips. SPE pipette tips provide a convenient means of processing a small amount of sample and can be used to either retain undesired material or more commonly to selectively retain the analyte and then elute it with solvent. These were originally introduced with a pack sorbent bed held with a bed support. The reproducibility of these devices was greatly dependent on operator skill, and this original design has largely disappeared. Next part is, or next instrument is SPE discs. The small cross-sectional area SPE pipette tips are prone to plugging or plugging by protein samples. So, solid phase extractants are also available in filter form. Okay, that is M-Pol TM extraction discs are most commonly used for this purpose, in which 8 micrometer silica particles are enmeshed into a web of PTFE, that is polytetrafluoroethylene fibrils. Okay. Fiberglass base discs, which are more rigid, are also available for this purpose. Disc cartridges or disc preloaded in a plastic barrel are also available that operate like a regular cartridge. Next instrument is 96-well SP plates. Solid phase extraction systems have been designed in a 96-well microtiter plate format so they can be processed automatically. Single block plates with 96 wells contain either pack beds or discs of sorbent particle in an 8 row into 12 column rectangular format. In this diagram, you can see there is this instrument is known as 96 well SP plates, okay, where 8 rows into 20 columns are present. Next part is other sorbents for solid phase extraction. Sorbents are available in long chain lengths, that is C20 and C30, for isolation of hydrophobic molecules. Universal sorbents have been developed that will sorb a group of structurally similar compounds. An example is synthetic polymer of N-vinyl pyrrolidone, top half of molecule, and divinyl benzene, that is bottom half. Okay, so these are the sorbents which are used for the solid phase extraction method. It provides hydrophilicity for wetting and hydrophobicity for analyte retention. A sulfonated version is a mixture mode sorbent that has both ion exchange and solvent extraction properties, and it will retain a range of acidic, neutral, and basic drugs. These wettable sorbents do not require conditioning. Okay. Then let us see some phases which involve in this solid phase extraction method. First one is polymeric phases. Beside the common silica based SP particles, polymer based support are also available. These have advantages of being stable over a wide pH range, and they do not possess residual silanol groups, that is hydroxyl groups, residing on the surface of unmodified silica gel that can interact with, for example, metal ions or other cationic spaces. The particles are spherical, while silica-based SP particles are irregular in shape, and the polymeric particles have been designed to be wettable. They typically have higher capacity than silica-based particles. And second phase is dual phases, in which the use of two different phases can extend the range of compounds which can be extracted. Three types are used: mixed mode, layered mode, and stack phases. In the mixed mode, two different types of chemically bonded phases are mixed together in the cartridge. An example is mixture of C8 and cation exchange particle. In the layered mode, the two different phases are packed one on top of the other. And in third layer, that is stack phases, use two cartridges in series to provide the enhancement of separation method. The first two modes are more readily adapted to automation since only a single cartridge is used. So this is about the solid phase extraction technique. Now let us see the application. This technique is used for the extraction and purification of compound. Solid phase extraction procedure are used not only to extract traces of organic compounds from environmental sample, it is also used for the extraction procedure, or sorry, purification procedure. It is also applicable, or application of solid phase extraction technique, in analysis of different compounds in various matrices. Analytical laboratories use solid phase extraction to concentrate and purify the sample for analysis. Solid phase extraction, it can be used to isolate the analytes of interest from a wide variety of matrices, including urine, blood, water, beverages, soil, and animal tissue. So there is one technique is present in solid phase extraction technique, is known as solid phase micro extraction technique. Okay, so let us see what is meant by SPMA. It is a solvent free extraction technique typically used for analyte collection for determination by gas chromatography, or sometimes by using high performance liquid chromatography. solid, liquid or gaseous matrices can be sampled by using this technique. The principle of extraction is based on like dissolves like. That is, good extraction efficiency can be obtained by a fiber with matching polarity to that of the target analyte. So this is the micro syringe which is used for this purpose or in this technique, that is solid phase extraction, micro extraction technique. The key feature of this device is an extraction fiber protected inside the needle of a syringe. A typical SPME fiber is made up of few silica coated with a thin layer, that is, which is made up of 7 micrometer to 100 micrometer thickness of immobilized polymer or a solid adsorbent or a combination. In a solution or head space, that is vapor in equilibrium with the solution in a closed system, analytes are exposed to the fiber and distribute between the sample matrix and the fiber coating during extraction. The fiber is exposed to a gaseous or liquid sample or the headspace above a solid or liquid sample for a fixed time and temperature. Samples are often agitated to increase the extraction efficiency. After extraction, the fiber is withdrawn back into the needle and directly transferred to the GC injector port, where the analyte is thermally dissolved and introduced into the GC column for separation. For LC analysis, the fiber can be introduced into a specially designed chamber for solvent desorption. A widely used fiber is based on polydimethyl siloxane, that is PDMS coating, which is relatively nonpolar due to the presence of methyl groups. This fiber is useful for sampling nonpolar volatile or semi-volatile compounds and can be used to determine flavor components from beverages, foods and the another compounds. Another example is a fiber with 85 micrometer coating of polyacrylate. It is more polar due to the presence of carboxyl groups and thus it is used to extract polar compounds such as phenols. Okay, so this is about the solid phase micro extraction technique which is used further for with the HPLC or gas chromatography technique.